Hello and welcome to the show. I am here on BeamNG Drive with a challenge. Today I'm going to be seeing how quick I can get the normal cars in the game. I'm not going to be using any mods for this. I'm going to see how higher a top speed I can achieve with some vehicles on here. I mean, I've done plenty of driving, but I've never actually done sort of proper speed runs. I don't know how much speed I can get out of these vehicles. I'm going to be using the East Coast USA map. Again, no mods involved at all in this. There are, I have found, various maps that are sort of much larger, wide open roads for you to really max the cars out, but I want this to be a little bit of a challenge as well. So I'm using a kind of normal road. It is a relatively long, relatively straight road. However, there are bumps, there are slight kinks, slight corners to deal with. It's lined with trees, there's a bridge. Things can go wrong, and if things do go wrong with the kind of cars that I'm going to be using for this, they are going to go wrong big time. Like, we're going to have some monumental accidents in this one if I lose control of the vehicles. The way it's going to work, for a run to count, I must bring the vehicle to a controlled halt. There is a petrol station that is going to mark the finish point of the run. I've got to try and achieve as high a top speed as I can before hitting the petrol station. But as I said, you know, the road here is not a perfect thing to navigate around. The cars have got to be good to control as well as powerful. Oh, we've lost it. Oh, that's actually quite tame. That's gonna hurt though. Oh no, for a big crash with on this sort of a road, that is relatively tame. That's even vaguely survivable, I think, maybe in mid-D series. Okay, first attempt, we got just past about 110 miles an hour, I think, at the point in which we lost control of the truck. This is the difficulty that the vehicles have got to be dealing with, essentially. We were going to be doing 120, 150, I don't know how fast we can go. I don't know whether we can crack 200 miles an hour with any of these cars, but I've got to try and keep control of them on this kind of a road, which I think is a great challenge. And as I said, when the things do go wrong, the accidents tend to be quite spectacular. Now the trick with this is, of course, smoothness. I've got to be very smooth. You can see here where things went wrong. I've done better. Got to be very, very smooth with the steering. Things are going good with the D-Series. 121 miles an hour in the pickup truck. 123. Oh, we're wandering. We're wandering. Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Oh, no. Oh, dear. Ow. Oh. That's a big one. That is a really big shunt. We were wandering towards the bridge and there is a slight bump coming onto it. And that's the outcome. We got about 123 miles an hour. It is not a good idea to get a wobble on at 123 miles an hour. I mean, that is literally just the second we hit the bridge, that was game over. The truck was rolling as soon as we hit the landing then. Admittedly, rolling does help for these in these accidents. When the car is rolling, that's dissipating energy, so the actual kind of finished shunt isn't as bad. If this goes straight into something at 120, it's going to be a big accident. So yeah, if it flips and rolls, then we're kind of okay. The trick, certainly with this D-Series, very, very smooth with the steering. It's incredibly easy to upset. Let's face it, pickup truck doing 120 miles an hour is quite ridiculous. Very easy to upset it as we go down here. 125, I think we've got 127. There we go. Across the bridge. We've got control. Oh, no, no. Don't lose control of it now. Oh, brakes. Oh, no. I mean, we've kind of came to a controlled halt. That was definitely, you know, survivable. We already cracked a wheel. Look at that. The camber and toe on that front wheel. I mean, we almost, we're getting closer. We almost got it under a controlled halt on that one. About 127 miles an hour we're looking at in this one. This is the most powerful version of the truck. I didn't go for off-road suspension. Didn't go for like the big off-road truck for kind of obvious reasons. We're having enough issues keeping this thing on its wheels. The off-road truck will fall over very, very easily because of the high center of mass in it. It's got the ground clearance to deal with the bumps, but that means when you travel at 110 miles an hour, it doesn't take much to topple the thing over. So that's why I've gone for this version of the vehicle. It actually gets up to the speed pretty quickly. We do just run out of puff, basically, at the 127 mile an hour mark. Admittedly, that is also helped by the slightly going downhill bits on here. Come on, D-Series, we can do it this time. Little gentle movements with the steering as we come up towards the bridge now. 126. Oh, keep your foot down, keep your foot down. We've still got a little bit of road to go. About 100 again, a similar sort of speed. Oh, there we go. Look at that. And rest. I think it was about the 127 mile an hour. I think it did flick up to like 130, but that's because we were bouncing about a little bit. Okay. We have made a completed run. 127 miles an hour is the time, or the speed, I should say, to beat. So, our next vehicle to go down the dangerously speed road is the Covert. Now, there are two possible options, the race or rally version. Both of them, of course, very, very quick. I went for the rally version of this one. Seeing as, well, the suspension is unlikely to cause the car problems with rolling over, unlike with the off-road version of the truck, and it might be enough to hopefully survive the bumps of the course, survive the demands of this particular circuit. So we're looking at about 127-ish miles an hour to beat for the Covert, and I don't think this is actually going to do it. I think this may be not quite quick enough. Oh no, we do have a sixth gear. Okay. Maybe with some downhill bits, we can get the Covered up to speed. Much more controllable, this car, I will say that much. We're at 117. Oh, we're going to crack 120. There we go. We're still picking up speed. 122, 6, 4, 5, 6, 127. Oh, we're going to do it, are we? Yeah, we actually got all of the control. No, not got the control. Control has gone AWOL. There. It did so well. Really know what happened there. Everything went fine. It landed the jump. The control was okay. And then it all happened so fast, and now the Covert is upside down. That was a surprising accident. Yeah, that, things were going absolutely perfectly well, and then all of a sudden, upside down Covert. Let's try not to do that one again. I mean, this is much easier to drive down here. It much prefers these sort of speeds, as you can imagine. Let's face it, you know, doing 120 miles an hour in a little hatchback is perhaps more sensible than doing 120 in a great big heavy pickup truck. So yeah, you know, this handles much better. It handles the speed. I mean, you still got to be delicate. If I do anything too crazy with the steering, we are going to go into a tree at very, very high speeds. But down here, I've not really got much fear with this car. 120 miles an hour again. Come on, we can get some more. 122. Let's get some more of that speed. Again, it's a very similar speed. 127 we got on the speedo. Right, make the turn down here. Ah, it was that bump that caused us issues. Okay, oh, no, no. Uh-oh. Trees! Ooh. Ow. That was admittedly slower than it had been going. Ah, there is a secondary bump. There is a secondary bump in this course. It's just before the petrol station. See, I was thinking the bridge was going to be the big issue for bumpiness, essentially, because you do pretty much jump the bridge at 120. So the cars have got to deal with taking that airtime. And so far, the pickup, and this has actually done really well on that landing. The Covert's got more than enough control, and it's not really going fast enough to have issues on this part of the course. You know, relatively simple choice of car, if you like. There are only about 110 change in direction slightly through there. The Covert's not going to have a problem with that. Also, being front-wheel drive, we're unlikely to have the back end go incredibly loose on you at any point down here. Right, we've got to do better with the stopping it. It's again 127 miles an hour as we cross the bridge. I don't think we're going to get any more out of it though down here. So we're going to bring it under control. Brakes, carefully does it. There we go. Control has been found in the Covert. You will notice at times there I was letting off the brakes trying to sort stuff out, so that I don't want to lock the brakes up and completely lose control of the car. So at times you will see me letting off the brakes just to straighten the car up before going back on them again. And it worked. We've got the car all back under control. So it is a tie, pretty much. I will have to go back and check the D-Series, the more precise. When I'm going to go back to check it, definitely got 127 miles an hour out of the Covert. So yeah, so far the pickup and this have been going remarkably similar for straight line speed. So next on the list of vehicles to have a go, the Grand Marshal, the bigger V8 powered one. So this should have more power than the Covert. The question is, will it have the control? Rear-wheel drive this, we're more likely to lose the back end on the high-speed bumps and the slight changes of direction. We're also probably likely to be approaching these at higher speeds. And this isn't a rally version of the car, so it hasn't got fancy trick suspension and so on. Yeah, I mean, we're doing 15 miles an hour more than we were doing in the Covert. Oh, uh-oh, oh no, 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 no. Somehow, oh no, we're gonna lose that. I'm not gonna stop. Hey, oh, trees. No, these crashes have been quite tame. I will be honest. I mean, that's a 115 mile an hour spin out in between trees, and I have managed to. I mean, all of the wheels are broken. Oh no, wait, we've got one good wheel. The rear right is okay. Anything else is gone, and the rear bumper is gone. And amazingly, that was quite survivable. It'd be uncomfortable, and you would definitely need new underwear. Surprisingly tame crash for losing the back end, and it just didn't have the grip to try and recover the car in all of that. Okay, but immediately, I mean, this seems quicker. We got 115 before we got to kind of the first real kink in the straight. So we are perhaps expecting this. We could see this get up to maybe 130, 140 miles an hour, possibly, from the Grand Marshal. But then my fears are that 140 miles an hour might not be that controllable in this car, because we saw the back end at 115 through here was not happy about letting go. I've got to be really ultra speedy, because I love you could see the tire tracks on the next run where things went wrong. I love how long it took me to have an accident as well. Okay, 130 miles an hour in the Grand Marshal, up towards 140. Oh no, oh no, 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 bridge! Ow, that was a painful one. Oh dear. Yeah, that's... God, the railing straight through the driver's seat in that one. I lost the back end coming down. I was pushing my luck, and I just overcorrected the steering. Just a tiny little bit overcorrected the steering. And that's quick into the bridge there. Okay, I know I said that the crashes so far had been relatively tame. That's 140 into the side of the bridge there. Let's not try and do that one again. I kind of fear what this car might do across the bridge. I do think we could have potential issues trying to take 140 miles an hour across the bridge in a vehicle like this. I have no doubt that the more race-ready, more race-prepared cars will have no issue, and the pickup had no issue getting across there. But this, quite heavy, not the best grip. We might have the back end let go on the landing, essentially. So, yeah, that could be interesting. We're up to about 136 miles an hour, though. I saw it tick over to 142 miles an hour as we cross the bridge. Back ends let go. Trees! And, I mean, the first tree actually took a lot of that impact. The first tree took... I was expecting to hit the really big tree, but we got caught. We got caught by the little trees, and... Yeah, the fears that I had with the Grand Marshal is that we're going to lack control in this car. Now, admittedly, once we've got 140, I can potentially go on the brakes. I mean, this is all about getting the maximum speed before the petrol station. I don't have to still be going flat out when I hit the petrol station. And if we can't carry the speed across the jump, then if I want to keep the car under control, slowing it down a bit is a sensible idea once I've got that 140 plus mile an hour speed. I also, though, do fear that if I do try to get on the brakes, that may cause more control issues for the car. Right, here we go, 145 miles an hour. We took the jump better, we've got the back end under control, we took the secondary jump better, now I'm going to jump on the brakes, wiggle, no, tree! Oh, bugger. That was closer. That was much closer. Again, it's the whole, how long do you hold the brakes and do you risk locking the brakes up? We were still carrying so much overspeed coming down here. Pretty much once we've cleared the bridge, we're having to get ready to start slowing down. We definitely have to take the bridge jump the middle. We have to be very much in the middle of the road to survive getting across this bridge. If we're either side of it and the back end lets go a little bit, we're going to hit the side of the road or the scenery, whereas if we're in the middle and the back end lets go a little bit, I have just that fraction of a second to regain control, just that little margin for error, little wiggle room to get the car back under control. So that is something that is important, and then we've got to get ready to bring the car to a halt neatly as we go past the petrol station. So right again, right in the middle of the road, back end is let go, we're going to find the same tree. Oh, that time the little shrubbery wasn't there to catch us. Oh, that doesn't look much like a Grand Marshal from the front anymore. If we look at it from maybe this angle, it kind of gets away with it. Ow. That's a very, very similar incident, is that trying to catch that back end in time in this car is the difficulty, really, with this one. Lots of speed available in this particular car. I'm starting to get the hang of up here. I can be smooth enough to keep the car on the road through this section that we're coming up to here. Actually, about, oh no, I had to say something. To bloody say something, didn't I? That was straight into the trees. I just took a glance down at the speedo and realised I was actually approaching that corner a lot faster than I had done in previous runs. I think perhaps I was just sort of lifting slightly coming up to that that approach with a slightly lower speed. I was doing a better job of controlling it. Apparently, well, you know how it works with FailRace stuff. The minute you say it's going well, the minute you've got the hang of something, that's when you're going to have a big accident. So yeah, we're going to sort of just coast a little bit through here so as to not overload the rear tyres. It just doesn't have the grip, this car. Really doesn't have the grip to carry the speed. I may have been a little too slow through there, I think, to get perhaps the maximum. We do still go downhill, though, down this section. We are a little bit slower. It's only about 142 miles an hour as we cross the jump. Can I get it under control, though? Oh, no! We're in the trees, and we're going to smack our back of the car into that one there. Oh, and that's killed. That's killed the driveline. Right, we will have one more go with the Grand Marshal to complete the run cleanly. It has done 145, and it was a survivable crash at the end of it, but it still was a little bit of a shunt with a tree. I would like to get a run and get the car under control, but I'm not going to keep going on forever with this vehicle. Decent speed from the Grand Marshal, decent power and so on from this car, but we lack the control. We lack the rear end grip, really, to keep this all together across the demands of this particular road. Okay, I think we're doing a little bit better this time around. Yeah, we're going to hit the 140 odd mile an hour mark. I'm a little too far to the left, I fear. Oh, no, we're across the jump better. This is where we're going to get hurt. Oh, no. Ah. Well, the Grand Marshal quick, but as we will leave it stuck in the signpost, it fails on the account of a lack of control. There is just not the rear end grip in this vehicle. Up next, it is the turn of the Moonhawk. Now, there is a drag version of this car. I am not using the drag version because, well, it doesn't really steer. And as we have seen, this course requires some steering. However, this has got the same engine as the drag version. So we should have a similar kind of top speed, and it might actually be, it might actually be controllable, which is going to burn the rear tyres out completely. Yeah, supercharged V8 in this thing should theoretically be very, very fast. The thing is, we've got to try and control the damn thing. We've got to try and maintain all of the fury that is inside this vehicle. And as you can see, we're already doing 120 long before we get here, and that was with a silly start and much fighting for control. Little movements with the steering, we were playing that really very, very close with the wall. 140 miles an hour heading down here now at this stage. We're about to hit 150 miles an hour. I'm trying to push the car. 153. Are we going to? Not going to get control of that. That's going to go off the wall. Oh, the tree suckered us in. Holy crap. It's pulled the entire chassis apart at the front there. Bloody hell. That is a nasty, nasty shunt. This is a very, very quick car. But the couple of things, and we'll actually slightly let this down over the likes of the supercars. The gearbox is only a 4-speed gearbox in this car, and we do kind of run out of gear ratios a little bit as we're going down here. I mean, the control issues are far more of a problem than the running out of the gears, but you know, there we go. 115, so we were 115 long before the Grand Marshal would ever get near it, and this is with being incredibly careful and spinning the wheels manically off the start. Now we can unleash some of the power down here. Now we can unleash... Oh, I tried to go full throttle and we just spun the wheels. Let's unleash a little bit more of that fury. 150, 160 miles an hour we get down here. We bounce off the bridge. Oh, I'm trying to get it under control again. That was not too bad, actually. Oh, as I say that, we're going to go for a spin. But I will gather it all up again. And there we go. When it's a spin like that in the middle of the road, that's fine. I can deal with that one. That's not a problem. Gathering the Moonhawk back up again. Right, 160 miles an hour is our new target mark for these vehicles to try and beat. We've got to do some celebratory donuts. Yeah, we cracked the windscreen across the bridge. The rest of the damage on this car, though, is all from the... Well, ending up in that ditch over there while messing about with it. So, Moonhawk is quick and surprisingly controllable, despite hitting the bridge at far higher speeds. Our next challenger is the 200BX. This is the turbo race version of the car. This should stand a pretty good chance of being controllable and having plenty of speed. Well, I'm hoping controllable. I fear a little bit of oversteer, but let's face it, this and the massively supercharged Moonhawk, that's probably just as oversteery as this particular car. I'm hoping we will have some decent control in this one. We're 120 miles an hour already, 125 as we go over the crest here. Oh, I've lost that back end. We're not stopping that. Treed! Whoa, many of the rotations. I don't know how many rotations that one was. That was a lot. I thought we might have... I don't know why I naively thought with that wing on the back we might have the downforce to get away with going that brave. We didn't. Oh, look, the wheel's still going. Where's it going to... Oh, it's not going to roll down the road nicely. Nope, it's going to wibble and wobble and... Oh, it's coming our way. Wheel, come back. You're aware we're missing lots of important parts at the front of the car, I will be honest here. Oh, it's still going. Oh no, game has been ruined. God damn it, I was really hoping to see it come rolling past. Yeah, I may have got a little carried away. This thing is so broken that the steering is not even making an attempt to move anything. Oh no, tell a lie, there's something wiggling in there just about. Yeah, that was a really really heavy hit on the front of the car. Right, there is a lot of acceleration available in this car, so we will have to be careful coming up to the crest of the hill. We can't be flat out over here. I was going to have to give it a go with this car. I'd hoped we might have the control, but we aren't going to at about the 120 mile an hour mark, so we'll just calm it down by about 5 miles an hour, try and be as smooth as possible with the steering. You might be able to take it flat out if you're a lot smoother with the steering than I am. We are starting, though, to run out of straight-line speed. About 149, 150 miles an hour is all of the car that has got to give. No, I turned the steering too much. Turn the steering. I realized I'd made a mistake the second I'd bounced on the landing, but at the speeds I was going, I couldn't stop it. There's nothing I could do to stop the car from doing that. Just a fraction too aggressive with the steering. Just corrected it a little too much, and I knew that was going round. Okay, so we run out about 150 miles an hour. Now we may possibly... I'm going to try this again flat out down here. I'm going to try not lifting. I'm going to try and be really super smooth with the steering. Super precise. I say super precise. I should never say this sort of thing, so I know it's not going to work. Bloody hell, we are really shifting now as we come over this crest of the hill. Okay, there it is flat out. Tiny movements on the thumbsticks there to make that one stick. Okay, you can do it. It is quite scary, though, and even that... with being pretty damn precise. 155, I think, 154 miles an hour we got to. Oh, front end's going up. Front end's in the air. Front end in the air, and I'm not going to get any control of the car. That was unfortunate landing. That was a very unfortunate bump across the bridge. Technically, got glitched out a little bit. That was unlucky. The front end didn't want to come down again. And the second that that's up in the air, well, you're steering. You're not going to get any of that with the front wheels floating around in thin air. So I couldn't avoid anything in time. And, you know, the brakes, sure, I can try and jump on the brakes. But again, I've only got the rear wheels just about vaguely on the ground. So that's not going to work. Right, let's try again. We got better speed out of the car that time by being super brave. Oh, don't bounce across there, you moron. That's not going to work. Little movements. That is terrifying. Oh, lots of corrections were going on there to try and make sure we didn't lose the back end of the car. Here we go, 150 miles an hour as we start plummeting downhill. 153 as we hit the bridge. We have lost the bumpers, but we can... Oh, brakes. Oh, we've done it. We've come to a rest cleanly. Admittedly, we have lost both front and rear bumpers. that was more the jump though that did that. So that I'm taking that as a victory for me. That was about 153, I think, ish miles an hour. Not quite as quick as the Moonhawk. You can go quicker over the crest of the hill in this car, but we run out of steam coming down the other side. There are bits of bumper collecting. collecting around here. Yeah, just slightly run out of steam coming down the other side. Moonhawk still leads, but 200 BS got pretty damn close, actually. It got pretty damn close and was definitely fastest at the first kink at the crest of the hill. We did sort of slightly undress it coming over the bridge, but yeah, I think that's pretty impressive going. Now, the question is, oh, I pressed the wrong button. I can never remember which is the button to bring the headlights up. I apologize. I'm going to see if the headlights still worked. I think they would have done. God damn it, my stupid. Okay, still though, pretty impressed with this car.